This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Fitness game, exergaming or exer-gaming, a portmanteau of exercise and gaming, or gamersizing is a term used for video games that are also a form of exercise. Exergaming relies on technology that tracks body movement or reaction. The genre has been credited with upending the stereotype of gaming as a sedentary activity, and promoting an active lifestyle. Research indicates that exergames can produce real improvements in fitness. Exergames are seen as evolving from technology changes aimed at making video games more fun. Contents 1 history 11 1980s 12 1990s 13 2000s 14 2010s 2 effectiveness 21 in the lab 211 children 212 adults 22 beyond the lab 23 injury 3 design trends 4 references 5 further reading history. The genre's roots can be found in games released in the late 80s, including the Foot Craze, which was the first such device, released for the Atari 2600 in 1987, and the Power Pad or Family Trainer, released for the Nintendo Entertainment System NES in 1988. Although both had limited success, Konami's Dance Dance Revolution was cited as one of the first major successes of exergaming. When it was ported from the arcade to PlayStation, it sold over 3 million copies in the 2000s. A number of devices and games have used the exergame style to much success. The iToy camera has sold over 10 million units, while Nintendo's Wii Fit has sold in excess of 21 million copies by June 2009. Health games were generating revenues of $2 billion, largely due to Wii Fit's 1,822 million sales at the time. The term exergaming entered the Collins English Dictionary in 2007. The genre has been mooted as a way to improve users' health through exercise, but few studies have been undertaken to measure the health benefits. Smaller trials have yielded mixed results and have shown that the respective traditional methods of exercise are superior to their video game equivalents. 1980s exergaming contains elements that were developed in the virtual reality community during the 1980s. The pioneer in this area was Autodesk, which developed two systems, the HiCycle and Virtual Racquetball. The HiCycle was an exercise bike that a user would pedal through a virtual landscape. If the user pedaled fast enough, the virtual bike would take off and fly over the landscape. Virtual Racquetball tracked the position and orientation of an actual racket that was used to hit a virtual ball in a virtual environment. This environment was shared with another user equipped with another tracked racket, allowing the two users to play each other over phone lines in both systems. The users could wear the VPL iPhones, an early head-mounted display HMD, that would provide more immersion for the user. The first true attempt at what would later be called exertainment was the Atari Puffer Project 1982. This was an exercise bike that would hook up to an Atari 400 800s or 5200 system. Forward speed was controlled by pedaling while steering, and additional gameplay was handled by a handlebar-mounted gamepad. The machine was nearly ready for production with several games, Tumbleweeds and Jungle River Cruise, when Atari declared bankruptcy and the Puffer Project was abandoned. Nintendo also dabbled in this space with the Power Pad in the late 1980s. The first exergaming system released to the market was the 1986 Computrainer, designed as a training aid and motivational tool. The Computrainer allowed users to ride through a virtual landscape generated on an NES, while monitoring data such as power output and pedaling cadence. The product had a price that was far too high to be considered as an entertainment product, but was affordable by dedicated athletes. The product continues to this day, where it now runs using Microsoft Windows-compatible software with extensive graphic and physiological capabilities. Also released for the NES in 1986 was the Family Trainer, which focused on entertainment rather than exercise about the same time as the Computrainer. Concept 2 introduced a computer attachment for their rowing machine. This has become their aero product and is used for both individual motivation as well as competition in indoor rowing leagues. 1990s. During the 1990s, there was a surge of interest in the application of virtual reality technologies to high-end gym equipment. Life Fitness and Nintendo partnered to produce the exertainment system. Precor had an LCD-based bike product, and Universal had several CRT-based systems. The NetPulse system provided users with the ability to browse the web while exercising. FitLinks introduced a system that used sensors attached to weight machines in order to provide automated feedback to users. The most sophisticated of these entries was the Tektrix VR bike, developed originally by Cybergear Inc. The VR bike allowed users to pedal through a number of virtual environments as well as engage in single and multiplayer games. It was joined later by the VR Climber. The VR bike software is now distributed alongside Trickster Bikes. Three issues combined to ensure the failure of these systems in the marketplace. First, they were significantly more expensive than the equivalent models that did not have all the additional electronics. Second, they were harder to maintain, and were often left broken. Lastly, the additional expertise required to operate the software was often intimidating to the users, who shied away from the machines out of fear that they would look foolish while trying to master the machine. Until 1998, nothing significant happened in the field of video game exercise hardware was still too expensive for the average home consumer, and the health clubs were gun-shy about adopting any new technology as high-performance game console capabilities improved and prices fell. Manufacturers once more started to explore the fitness market in 1998. Konami's Dance Dance Revolution was released 2000s. In 2000, UK startup Exertris introduced an interactive gaming bike to the commercial fitness market. Exergaming came to the mass media attention at the Consumer Electronics Show when Bill Gates showcased the Exertris interactive gaming bike in 2003, and the following year the same show hosted a pavilion dedicated to video game technology that also worked as sports and exercise equipment. GamerSize played on PlayStation. The 2005 release of the iToy, Kinetic, brought the first, multi-function, Exergame hardware into the home market, making the player's physical movements into the game's controller. 2006 saw the launch of GamerSize, combining traditional fitness equipment with games consoles. The minimalist approach allows gameplay to continue only when exercising, turning all game titles into potential Exergames. Nintendo's Wii in 2006 brought acceleration detection with the Wii Remote. In late 2007, Nintendo released the Exergame Wii Fit, which utilized a new peripheral, the Wii Balance Board. Various approaches to Exergames have been documented and compared by Videojug in an information film. The popularity of the Wii led to being used in hospital rehab rehabilitation programs. The PC Gamer Bike appeared at CES in 2007, where it received an honorary award. It differs from other Exergaming devices in that its pedal motion can be mapped to any key on the keyboard. It also has an optical encoder which detects forward and reverse pedal motion. The Fisher-Price Smart Cycle was another entry in the field. Other examples of Exergaming products include Positive Gaming Idents, iStep, Cobalt Flux, Bluefit, CyberCoach, NeoRacer, GymKids exercise equipment with interactive technology. Some Wii titles such as EA Sports Active, Cybex Tracer, PowerGrid Fitness, Kilowatt, Lightspace, Play Floor, PlayMotion, Yourself Fitness, Espresso Fitness S2, iPlay, Cyber Exercycle, VEQTOR Sport Trainer, and Sportwall. 2010s. The Kinect 2010 represented a significant advance in how player motion was detected in games, because the player's body became the remote. Mobile phone apps such as Zombies Run 2012, Ingress 2013, and Pokemon Go 2016 have been described as augmented reality. Exergames effectiveness in the lab. In order to better understand Exergaming's relationship with physical activity, laboratory studies have compared Exergames to both traditional seated video games and other physical activities. For example, treadmill walking. Consistent evidence demonstrates Exergaming requires more energy and has the potential to raise heart rate in comparison to traditional seated video games and rest. Overall, most Exergames are equivalent to light to moderate activity for both adults and children. For example, Electronic Arts commissioned a 2010 study by the University of Wisconsin that found that EA Sports Active passed fitness guidelines for an effective workout put forth by the American College of Sports Medicine. However, while the Wii has been seen as being more physically demanding than sedentary game consoles, a study published in the British Medical Journal found that while playing the Wii uses significantly more energy than playing sedentary computer games, the energy used when playing active Wii games is not of high enough intensity to contribute towards the recommended daily amount of exercise in children. Based on a systematic review on active video games for youth, none of the games elicited an average energy expenditure above 6 MET threshold for vigorous energy expenditure when used at intermediate or high intensity. Exergaming can improve fitness. Children energy expenditure. Energy expenditure during Exergames differs only slightly from other traditional light to moderate intensity physical activities. Most Exergames elicit energy expenditures between light and moderate intensities, although in some studies a sizable percentage of players have performed at vigorous activity levels. Exergames which only require upper body movement typically result in energy expenditures equivalent to light physical activity, while Lower and whole body movement games provide activity of at least a moderate intensity. Citation needed. Several studies have been done to see what types of exercise gamers get while playing these types of games and to see if children really benefit from the activities. Overall, the research indicates exergaming has the potential to increase physical activity, which is always a benefit anytime physical activity is an improvement over sedentary time on the couch. Heart rate. Exergames increase heart rate compared to resting. Those which require whole, lower body movement produce a greater increase in heart rate than those which use only upper body movements. Different games requiring similar movements for gameplay do not necessarily have the same impact on heart rate. For example, games played on dance mats have increased heart rates to levels similar to those of moderate and even vigorous intensities, whereas games played using a balance board have produced heart rates less than that of a brisk walking pace. Although both require lower body movement, it has been argued that heart rate is not a good proxy for energy expenditure for exergames, as several studies have shown heart rate to increase for sedentary video games. Body composition and BMI. Few exergaming studies have examined actual changes in body composition over time. Instead, estimates have been made based on laboratory gameplay. For example, it has been suggested that if exergaming were to take place at a similar intensity outside the laboratory, children would have the potential to lose 25. Using traditional handheld controllers, heart rate exergamers experience a greater increase in heart rate after 30 minutes of Wii Fit's free run than treadmill walking at 35. Time test and self-reported balance confidence. Additionally, anecdotal evidence suggests the Nintendo Wii can be used as part of a falls rehabilitation program. Studies have demonstrated increases in dynamic balance, a reduction in timed up and go scores, which measures mobility, and improvements in static balance after Wii usage. However, most of these studies tend to be case studies. Additionally, few exergames have been designed specifically for elderly, and we lack knowledge about the characteristics of the movements elicited by exergames and thereby about their potential to train functions important for fall risk reduction. Moreover, exergames provide better user experience if games are developed specifically for older adults. More robust evidence is needed to warrant the inclusion of exergaming in falls prevention programs. Upper extremity dysfunction. Upper extremity dysfunction results from a variety of different diseases and disorders. The degree of dysfunction ranges from the subject's self-reported pain, weakness, and impairment of the shoulder, elbow, wrist, and hand, to larger symptoms such as debilitating post-stroke. Multiple studies have chosen to incorporate the Wii into both movement therapy and exercise regimens for patients displaying these symptoms, in order to test whether the use of Wii's motion controller will benefit these patients through a kind of gaming rehabilitation. A study done by Xu et al. Examined the effect of Wii bowling on shoulder motion range. Elderly long-term care patients with upper extremity debilities supplemented their standard exercise regimen by playing Wii Sports bowling with the affected arm for 20 minutes at least twice a week. For 1 month, this resulted in an overall improvement of patients' active range of shoulder motion, as well as better scores in the modified PACES physical activity enjoyment scale and the NHPPT nursing home physical performance test. Research has also shown a positive effect from Wii Sports movement therapy for stroke patients. Stroke patients with upper limb dysfunction underwent movement therapy consisting of monitored, intense Wii Sports gaming for 2 weeks. These patients displayed improved functional use of their dominantly affected arm and hand, along with an increase in joint range of motion. Furthermore, significant clinical improvement on test metrics such as the WMFT Wolf motor function test and Malcom motor activity log. Quality of movement suggests that the skills gained from Wii-based movement therapy are transferable to daily living activities beyond the lab. One primary goal of exergaming is to get children or adults off the couch, and more active laboratory studies showing brief increases in physical fitness as a result of exergaming may not translate to real-world improvements. A 2013 systematic review of randomized controlled trials and before-after studies of exergames beyond the lab showed that exergames are associated with a better outcome in BMI, weight, with some evidence for improvements in VO2 max and adherence to exercise. The review called for more research on the mechanisms that make exergames effective. Individual studies vary in their findings. One study of children in actual homes over an extended period did not show lasting changes to their exercise habits. This study revealed no evidence that children receiving the active video games were more active in general, or at any time, than children receiving the inactive video games. Exercise physiologist Anthony Barnett suggested the results of the study are predictable. He said that children compensate for the increased activity of exergaming by reducing their exercise in other parts of their lives, resulting in no net gain when designing interventions that incorporate exergaming. Guidelines on frequency and duration of usage should be given to participants. Benefits of exercise on mental ability and productivity are in the early stages of research, but indications from using gamersize with a computer have been reported as providing a 17% productivity improvement. Combining cardiovascular exercise and balance practice has been shown to increase academic success among students in grades K-12, according to the 2009 Active Healthy Kids Canada report card on physical activity for children and youth. Children who are physically active perform better in school than those who are not. Interestingly, academic performance improves even when academic learning time is reduced to allow time for physical activity. A different question is whether exergaming affects beliefs about and attitudes toward physical activity. For example, in a 6-week program incorporated into 5th-grade physical education lessons in Singapore, children who were exposed to threat-framed messages about physical activity and who also played Wii exergames developed more positive attitudes and higher perceived behavioral control than children who were only exposed to the messages. The effectiveness of maintaining interest in exercise using traditional fitness machines has been examined with gamersize and found to be 6 times more sustainable than exercise alone. Injury. See also, video game related health problems. After the Wii was released, there were several cases of injury related to using the Wii, often dubbed Wiiitis. Injuries can be like tennis elbow. Players were cautioned that even the level of exercise needed to use the Wii could cause injury. Design trends. When making an exergaming system, the manufacturer of a consumer product must make the decision as to whether the system will be usable with off-the-shelf games or if custom software must be written for it, because it takes longer for a user to move their entire body in response to stimulation from the game. It is often the case that dedicated software must be written for the game to playable. An example of this is Konami's Dance Dance Revolution, though designed to be played by users moving about on a specially designed dance pad. That game can alternatively be played by pushing buttons with one's fingers using a standard handheld gamepad. When played with the dance pad at higher levels, the game can be quite challenging and physically exhausting, but if the game is played using the buttons on the hand controller, none of the sequences are physically limited. Newer systems such as Xbox 360, PlayStation 3 and Wii use alternative input devices such as the Kinect and PlayStation Move. The Move uses image analysis to extract the motion of the user against a background and uses these motions to control the character in the game. A specifically designed exercise game, Kinetic, superimposes animated objects to be punched, kicked, or otherwise interacted with over a video image of the user. The Wii and PlayStation 3 both incorporate motion sensors such as accelerometers and gyroscopes into the handheld controllers that are used to direct behaviors within the game. Research projects such as exertion interfaces that investigate the design aspects of these games explore how the technological augmentation that comes with the digital gameplay component can be nurtured for additional benefits, such as utilizing the social power of exercising together even though players are connected only over a network, or scaling the amount of players, enabling novel exercise experiences not available without the technological augmentation. Exergame resellers have developed fitness centers and specialist room designs with programs that focus entirely on creating environments for young people using exergaming for fitness. Group fitness programmer Les Mills International has recently launched immersive fitness studios around the globe, which combine exergaming with live group fitness classes. One of the newest trends is using virtual reality immersion utilizing an omnidirectional treadmill, such as the Infinidex. Such a system allows the user to virtually be in the game while allowing 360 degrees of movement. While the technology is new, it is showing promising results in weight management as well as in high participation rates. References. Carrot Wii Fit fitness game. Nintendo retrieved on the 2nd of August 2013. Carrot Gamersizing retrieved the 15th of July 2016. Carrot Van Aarem, Amy. January 10, 2008. Exergaming helps jumpstart sedentary children. The Boston Globe retrieved the 8th of August 2009. Subscription required help. Gamasutra retrieved on the 8th of August 2009. Carat financial results briefing for the 3-month period ended June 2009. PDF Nintendo the 31st of July 2009. P. Carat video jugsam the 11th of September 2007. How to use video games to keep fit. Beauty. Carrot, we players need to exercise too. BBC News Online, the 21st of December 2007, retrieved the 27th of August 2009. Carrot Nawaz, Ather, Skerrit, Nina, YST Mark, Christine, Helbosted, Jorun, Varakin, Beatrix, Svanis, Dag, the 26th of October 2014, Assessing Seniors User Experience UX of Exergames for Balance Training, Proceedings of the 8th Nordic Conference on Human-Computer Interaction Fun, FAST, Foundational, Nordici 14 doi, 101,145,26,391,892,639,235 retrieved the 28th of October 2015. The 23rd of June 2009. Carrot Table Tennis for 3 Exertion Interfaces retrieved on the 3rd of March 2010. Carrot is Virtual Reality The Future of Fitness CNN the 17th of June 2015 retrieved on the 9th of July 2015. Carrot Infinidec retrieved the 18th of December 2014. John Moores University, Liverpool, England VE Video Game Genres List Action Beat-em-up Hack and Slash Fighting Maze Pac-Man Clone Platform Shooter First Person Third Person Light Gun Shoot-em-up Tactical Survival Action Adventure Grand Theft Auto Clone Metroidvania Stealth Survival Horror Adventure Dating Sim Bishoho Eroge Otome Escape the Room Interactive Fiction Interactive Movie Visual Novel MMO MMO FPS MMORPG MMORTS Role-Playing Game Action Role-Playing Dungeon Crawl Mud Roguelike Tactical Role-Playing Simulation Construction and Management Business City Government Life Simulation Dating Sim Digital Pet God Social Simulation Sports Strategy 4X MOBA Real-Time Strategy Tower Defense Time Management Real-Time Tactics Turn-Based Strategy Turn-Based Tactics Artillery Wargame Vehicle Simulation Flight Simulator Amateur Combat Space Racing Kart Racing Sim Racing Submarine Simulator Train Simulator Other Genres Breakout Clone Exergame Incremental Music Rhythm Non-Game Party Programming Puzzle Sokoban Tile Matching Related Concepts Advertising Arcade Game Art Game Audio Game Casual Game Christian Game Crossover Game Cult Game Educational Game FMV Gamification Indie Game Nonlinear Gameplay Open World Nonviolent Video Game Online Game Browser Game Multiplayer Online Game Social Network Game Serious Game Toys to Life Traditional Game Twitch Gameplay Video Game Clone